Okay, in the last lecture, we have started our first unit. Okay, in the last lecture, we have started with our first unit, that is Introduction to the Transportation Engineering. We have started our first chapter, Introduction to the Transportation Engineering, and that we have seen modes of transportation. Okay, I will quickly review this what we have covered in the last lecture. The last lecture we have seen the modes of transportation. What are the modes of transportation? Railways, roadways, airways, and waterways. Okay, these are the modes of transportation that we have learned in the last lecture. In that first we have seen waterways. Okay, in the waterways we have discussed that water is the slowest among the all the four modes, but it needs the minimum energy to haul the unit load through the unit distance. This is what if you are going to the transportation through the water, then we require the amount of energy very less. Okay, haul the material whichever we are transporting through the water. Okay, it requires the minimum energy to drag or to haul the unit load through a unit distance. It requires the minimum energy. Okay, to transport the material from one place to the another. Okay, you connect the the complex network connections between the coastal ports. It connects the various coastal ports in the worldwide. Okay, it is the major transportation system internationally. Then we have seen some advantages of the water transportation. That is it is economical mode of the transportation to the bulk and heavy goods. If we have to transport the bulk amount of the material, heavy material, then the water transport through one country to the another country, then the water transportation system is the economical one. Okay, and it is very safe because the chances of the accidents through the water supply is very less. Okay, but through the water transportation, the chances of accidents are very less. Then we have seen it promotes the international trades. Okay, it connects the various international cities. Then it maintenance and construction route is very low as compared to the others. Okay, it is because it is naturally made routes. We do not need to construct the route to pass or to transport the material. Okay, it is a natural way to transport. Then we have seen some limitations. What are the limitations? To transport through the waterways, we need a required length as well as depth of the water. Okay, reach any particular place, we required particular depth of water as well as width of water so that the ship should pass through that water. Okay, it is very slow moving transport as compared to the airways. From one country to the another country, by the airway we can go quickly, but through the waterway we cannot go quickly. Okay, it is slow moving process, but the airway we require more money, through the waterway required less amount of money. And also through the waterway we can transport bulk amount of material, okay, heavy material, but we have the limitation to transport through the air. Okay, so both have their own advantages as well as own limitations to transportation. Okay. Then the adverse effect affected by the weather condition. If the weather condition is not good, we find the troubles to transport to the water. Then we require the maintenance cost for the ships. Okay. We need to repair, we need to painting time to time, because if there will be the any accidents happen in the mid of the sea, then it will not be work. Okay, then sea transport requires the large amount of investment. Okay, this we have seen the waterway. Then we have seen the railways. In that, the railway is the advantages for the long journey transport of the goods and passengers between the two stations. We have seen by the road, if we have to transfer the more amount of material and more amount of the passengers from one point to the another point, then the railway is the better option than the highway. Okay, railway is the better option than the highway, because the if you pass the more amount of passenger or more amount of the goods by the highway, then it will not be economical, as the railway has a very cheap amount of money required to transport the material. Okay, so railway is the economical one, and the roads can act as the feeder. Okay, but by the railway, we cannot service door to door. There is the limitations by the transportation through the railway. We cannot acquire all the villages. We cannot acquire all the cities by the railways. Okay, so to provide the door to door service, village to village service, every city service, we need to use the roads. Okay, so roads will be act as the feeder system. To go to the station, we required to use the roads. Okay, so road will act as the feeder system to the railways, waterways, airways. Okay, then the howling energy required for the railway is, as compared to the roadway, it is less. Whatever the howling energy required to drag the material, the energy required for the railway is less as compared to the road system, because the tractive resistance, we have learned in the applied mechanics, the tractive resistance to the road system is more as compared to the railway. Okay, the railway has the less tractive resistance than the highway. Then there are some advantages. We know to transport the bulk amount of material, railway is good than the highway. Then it has the quick movement of the goods from one place to another place in case of emergency. If there will be the famine, etc., then to transport the goods, clothes, the railway helps a lot. Okay. Then there is the less chances of accident as compared to the roadway system. As compared to the roadway system, the chances of accidents in the railway are less. Then the carrying capacity of railway is extremely large. Okay. The carrying capacity of the goods, passengers, is very large as compared to the road. If we need to transport the more amount of the material or the passenger, we just add the more wagons to the engine. Okay. As we going to add the more wagon, then the carrying capacity will be increased automatically. Yeah. Railway is the platform for the many public services. Yeah. Then we have seen also the disadvantages. What are the disadvantages? The construction cost. Main important disadvantages is the construction cost for the railway lines, to acquire the land, okay, then to build the stations, okay, to maintenance, to construct the railway. This cost, initial cost, is very high. Then, in case of traffic is not sufficient, the investment may be in wastage of the users. Very important point. Means whenever we plan for to build a railway line, as we are the engineer, future engineers, okay, if we get the project to build a railway line, then what we have to keep in mind? The area through which we are going to build the railway line, okay, in that area, there should be the huge traffic. Means what? We get more amount of goods, more amount of the passengers through that area. If not, there will be the wastage of our huge resource. Okay. So while planning the railway line, we have to plan like that. You should get the more traffic through that area. Okay. So and then only you will get the revenue from that route. Okay. You will get the whatever money you have invested in that project, you will get return. Okay. If there is a less traffic through that route, then there will be the wastage of money. So we have to keep in mind while designing the railway line or while alignment, first we have to decide the alignment through which area we should go through. While deciding that, we have to think about all the things. Means what? Land acquisition. Okay. Then the traffic through that route. That all the conditions we have to study very good. And then and only we have to plan for the railway line or railway route. Then the railway transport has another disadvantages is that its inflexibility means what? The timing schedule. We do not change the timing schedule of the railway line. If we visit the metro local trains of the Mumbai, the timing schedule is fixed. If you go a second also late, then we miss the train. Okay. Because the timing schedule is very complex at the Mumbai. So, but by the roadway, we can go anytime. We have a lot of bus, okay, to travel from one point to another point. We can't stop anywhere by requesting the driver. But in case of railway, we have to stop only on the stations, okay? Then the railway is not suitable for the short distance. If you have to transport the less material or less passenger for a short distance, then railway is not economical. Okay. But for that purpose, roadway is the best solution. If you have to transport the less amount of material or passenger for the less distance, then the roadway is the best option for that. Then we have seen the roadway or the highway system. In that, the transportation by the road is the mode which can provide us the maximum flexibility of the routes, type of vehicle, length, times. It will give the maximum flexibility. You can go anytime. You can use any vehicle. You can stop wherever you want. Okay. It gives the many flexibility as compared to the other, all other transport modes of the transportation. Then we have seen some advantages of the roadways. That is, it is cost effective. The cost is less to build the road as compared to the railway lines. Okay. Then it is ideal transportation system for the perishables, fruits and vegetables. Okay, because the fruits and vegetables will not last for the more time. It has less period of life. So, for transporting the perishables, that is fruits, vegetables, we have to use the roadways. Okay. Then highways are easy monitoring location of the goods. From anywhere we can pick the loads to anywhere we can transport. Okay. From one place to another place, to any place, because highways provides door-to-door system. Any point we can go, from any point we can pick up. Then we have seen the airways. The airway transportation is the fastest among all the four. Okay. The airway transportation system is fastest among all the four. Highway, railway, waterway. Okay. But the airway transportation is not economical. Okay. It requires more amount of money to travel through the airways. Okay. Then the transport, then the initial cost of the airway is also high. Okay, to build the aircrafts. Then the high speed. It's known for the high speed, quick service, no infrastructure investment because it goes air through. Okay, there will not be any obstructions to the air. Easy access. It can go over the mountain, over the forest, okay, over the sea. It need not require any road. It gives easy access. But while transporting the highway, need to go for the routes, which is easiest. Okay, but here is no, because we are going through the air, so there will not be any obstructions by the forest, mountains, seas. Okay, it will give us easy access. No physical barrier. It will always use the natural route. Then it also it is very importantly in the, it plays a very important role in the national defense system. Okay, airway plays very important role in the national defense system. Then what are the disadvantages? It is risky. Minor error is not acceptable in the airway transportation. It is very costly. Initial cost is very high. It has a small carrying capacity. The carrying capacity of the airway is very small. It is unreliable. That is, the weather condition, if the weather condition is suitable, then and then only we can go through the airways. If the weather condition is not good, we have to delay the flight. Okay. Then we required a huge investment. Okay, then we have seen the comparative study between the roadways and the railways. Okay, the roadways and railways, the suitability, the roadway, it is very suitable. We can use the bike, motorcycle, trucks, scooter, bicycle, container, etc. But by for the railway line, only we have to use the trains. Then right of way, we have seen the image in the last lecture. The right of way required more for the roadway and less for the railway. Then the tractive resistance, the roadway, for the roadway tractive resistance is high and for railway it is low. Okay. Then the turning device for roadway, it will not require any turning device, but for the railway it requires another engine for the turn. Okay. If you have seen at the mirror junction, etc., we have the turning. We have to go for the turning. Okay, and for the turning, we have to use the another engine for the from the another side. Then economy, less construction and maintenance cost for the roadway. And for railway, it requires high construction and maintenance cost. Then rate of accidents, as we all know, for roadway it is high, for railway it is very low. Then the roadways provides door-to-door system, door-to-door transportation, and the railway does not provide door-to-door transportation. Then also we have seen the different comparative study between the roadways and waterways. Suitability, by the roadway we can use anything, bicycle, motor, scooter, truck, container, four-wheeler, two-wheeler. But for the waterways, we have to go by ships, jets, boats, etc. Then the right of way, for roadway it is more, but in the waterway, we need not require right of way. Okay. As we are going to the water, then the tractive resistance for the roadway, it is high. And waterway also it is high, because the high tides will be there in the sea. So there will be the resistance of the high tides. Then there may be the weather condition, air, blow, etc. The turning device, not required for the boats. Then the economy, roadway have less construction and maintenance cost, as well as the waterway also have the less construction and maintenance cost. Then rate of accidents are high in the railway, but in the waterway there will be very less chances of the accidents. Okay, there are very less chances of accidents in the waterway. Then door-to-door transportation, roadway provides door-to-door transportation, but waterway does not provide. In all the modes of transportation system, only the roadway is there which provides the door-to-door transportation. Then the comparative study between the roadway and airways. Suitability, we can use bicycle, motor, scooter for the roadway, but for the airway, we have to use the planes, helicopter. Okay, right of way, for roadway it requires more, for airway it is also required to take off, to land. Okay, it requires right of way. Then the tractive resistance is both high. Then the turning turning devices. The turning device not required for both. Turning devices not required to the roadways as well as not required for the airway. Then economical, which one? The roadway is less economical, less construction and maintenance cost, but for the airway, there will require a huge amount of capital investment at the start. Okay. Then the point of comparison is rate of accident. There are higher rate of accidents in the both roadway and the airway. Then the roadway provides door-to-door transportation, but airway cannot provide the door-to-door transportation. Okay. So in all these four, the door-to-door transportation is provided only by the roadways. The fastest mode of transportation in these all four is airway. The slowest transportation through the all these modes of transportation is waterway. Okay. And the railway is the cheaper one. Okay. So these we have seen in the last. Okay. So now we'll move forward for the next point, the importance of the highway transportation. What is the importance of highway transportation? They facilitates the conveyance of the people's goods, raw material, manufactured article, etc., speedily and easily in the different parts of the country. If we have to move from one country to the another country, one state to the another state, one place to the another place, then the highway transportation system is a very important thing. Okay. If we convey the people, if we have to convey the goods, if we have to convey the raw material, any articles, speedily from the one point to the another point. Okay. So highway plays a vital role in that. Then the highway acts as the only source of the communication in the region of the high altitude, that is in the mountainous region. Okay. We cannot go through the railway into the mountainous region. Okay. We can go, but it will take the more amount of. Okay. But by the highway, we can go at the any point in the mountainous region also. Okay. If we have to go through the airway by the helicopter, then we require to use built a chopper. Okay. But by that, we can go only at that place. But by the highway, we can go the more places in the mountain also. Okay. So highway provides the only source of the communication in the region in the high altitude, that is the in mountainous region. Then the help in the growth of the trades and the other economical activities in and outside the villages and towns by establishing the contact between the towns and villages. It is a very important point, mode of transportation, that is highway, to connect the all villages with the towns, to connect the all the towns, okay, so that whatever transportation, okay, by to the development of the village, it is very important role to develop the villages as well. Okay. Highway plays the important role to development of the villages. Okay. They help the growth of the trade and the economical activities. Okay. As the economical activity enhances, the growth will be the increase. So the highway is very important. Okay. They help in the providing the efficient distribution of the agricultural products and the natural resources all over the country. Okay. By the highway, because of the highway, by the highway as well as because of the highway, we can provide the, all the agricultural material, that is fruits, vegetables, okay, from any point to the any point of the country. Also, they help to providing the improved medical facilities quickly to the human. Okay. To provide the ambulance, to provide the any extra medical facilities, fire, if there is the fire hazard. Okay. Then in that case also, the highway plays an important role to provide the quick access. Then the importance of 5A. Next, they help in the price stabilization of the commodity due to the mobile of the products all over the country. Okay, to reach the every villages, to reach every town, to reach every city, every state, the highway plays an important role so that the price stabilization will be there. Okay, they help in the cultural and the social advancement of the people and making the villages active and alert members of the community. Okay, in the previous years, the villagers will not that much active. Okay, they only knows to go to the field to work hard and to grow the vegetables, crops, etc. Okay, these only the work they do for the previous year. Okay, but now as all the villages are connected with the cities, etc., so that there is the help in the development of the cultural as well as the social advancement in the peoples by making the villages active and alert members of the community. Okay, so the highway plays the important role in that, to provide the access or the contact between the all the villages and the cities. Okay, they help in the promoting the cultural and the social ties among the people living in the different parts of the country, and thus they strengthen the national unity. But by the highway, we can go through the any state. Okay, from one state to the another. By the Maharashtra, we can go to Gujarat. We can see their culture. We can build a national bond between the countries. They can come to the our state. We can go to the Rajasthan, Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Gujarat, Jammu, Kashmir. Okay, we can go there. We can see their cultural. We can see their different activities. They can come here. They can build our culture. Okay, so that the whatever the national bond is there, national unity is there, we can build it by. So the highway helps into that to build the national unit. Then the highway provides the more employment opportunity who live in the rural area. Okay, for the rural peoples, it is very, in the previous year, it is very hard to go to the city and work. Okay, if they have to work, then they have to go to the city, live over there only, and then have to start the work. But now, as the transportation system is very easiest, we can go to the two wheelers, four wheeler from different cities and work there and back to the home at the evening. Okay, so by the highway, it gives the more opportunities to the worker from the villages to go to the city, work hard, and come back to the home. Okay, so it is very helpful to the areas which were not accessible by the roads, like villages. Okay, nowadays all the villages are covered by the highway, roadway, at least the village road. There are different kinds of roads: village road, district road, major district roads, state highways, national highways. Okay, at least we have go by the village road. We have provided the village road at the villages, at the rural areas. They enhance the land value, thus bring the better revenue. Okay, if we have seen, whenever we have to pass or align the highway through the any region, jab hum any highway banate hain through the any region, then we have to study the revenue that that farmer, that user, okay, we have to provide. Okay, suppose मेरा एक 4 एकड़ का क्षेत्र है, सो एंड उसमें से एक हाईवे जा रहा है. ओके, तो हाईवे की वजह से वहाँ के जो फार्मर है, उसकी जो खेती उसमें जा रही है, उसका टोटल रिवेन्यू मीन्स व्हाट, अप टू द 5 years, हाउ मच दैट लैंड कैन गिव टू द फार्मर. ओके, देन द मार्केट रेट ऑफ दैट हाईवे, field. Okay, that all the conditions we have to study and calculate the how much money we have to pay that to the. Okay. So in the case of famine, the highway plays an important role to provide or supplying the foods, clothes, etc. Okay. So that we will help their people to reduce their stress because of the famine. Then they help in the maintaining the better laws and the order into the country. Okay, there are the various laws. So how to use the highways, transport, how there are the traffic rules. Okay, that we have to learn. Okay, that is, I think, in the next sem or in the last year, you have that subject, traffic engineering, that you are going to learn all these things, how to use the highway, what are the traffic rules, traffic signs, signals. Okay, then the highway plays a very important role in the defense of the all of the country during the war days. Okay, in the war days, to transport the army, etc. Okay, the highway plays a very important role. Okay, to transfer the army from one point to the another point, to transfer the whatever the required for the war, what are the materials required in the war, that transport from one place to the another place. So highway carries very important role. Then lastly, it can say that the roads are the symbol of the country progress, and thus development made by any country can be judged by the quality and the network of its roads. This is very important. Whatever the country's progress is there, it is decided by the roads. Okay, how the roads of the country are there, what is the qualities of the road is maintained, how the network of the road system is there. By that, the country's development is decided. Okay, what is the progress of country is decided by the how the networks of the road is strong in that country. Okay, so these are the importance of the highway transportation that we have seen. Then the principles of the highway planning, what we have to see that in the principle, the plan to plan a road network for the efficient and the safe traffic operation with the optimum cost, which is very important. What is meant by optimum cost? That we need to build a highway in the optimum cost, okay, with the optimum period of the time. That means what? Whatever is the stipulated or decided design in the time is there, in that time only we have to construct the road, but with the optimum amount of cost. Okay, and we have to also provide the road network with the efficiency as well as with the safer traffic operation. There will be safe traffic operation. Safer traffic operation means what? The signs, signals, whatever the means, signs means what? Whenever you are traveling by the highway, you will observe various signs. Means what? Speed breaker is there. Please move your slow down your vehicle. The school is ahead. Okay, like that. The turn is there. Right turn is there. Left turn is there. Okay, these are the signs on the highway. Okay, then there will should be the signals at the junctions of the highways. Okay, so that these signs and signals should be there on the highway, so that there will be the safe movement of the traffic. Okay, so we need to do the plan of the road such that their road should be efficient enough. There will not be the high cost. There should be the optimum cost of the project, and we need to go through the safer traffic operation. Okay, that we have to keep in mind while we are planning the road. Then to arrive a road system and the length of the different categories of the road could provide the maximum utility and could be constructed within available resources during the plan period under the construction. Okay. While designing the load, we should also have to think about what this sub road means, what the different categories of road which are connecting to the main road. Okay, so that we should have the maximum utility of that road. Okay, if we have to construct a road and then there will not be any utility, okay, then the revenue by the road we are getting is very less. Okay, and maximum roads are built on the BOT process. BOT means what? Built, operate, and transferred. You may might be heard this sub word BOT. Built, operate, and transfer. Built, operate, and transfer means what? The government gives the build the authority to build the highway to the any agency. Then that agency builds the road. Then whatever revenue that the agency got by this road, that is by the toll plazas, etc. Okay, by that toll, the agency will get the revenue. Okay, after the it getting the whatever the cost they have invested, then the profit through that road it will take, and then the road will be handover to the government. Means what? Suppose we have to build a highway, national highway. Then what happens? The government choose any reputed agency. Okay, ask that agency to build that highway. Okay, then the agency will build that highway. The whatever cost it requires to build that highway, that cost is the whatever the money they have invested, it will be returned back by the tolls. Okay, we see that there will be a lot of tolls on the highway. Then they will get the revenue of that road by the tolls. Then when it they will get the money whatever they have invested plus profit, then that road or that tolls will be transferred to the government. Okay, that means that build, operate, and transfer. Build the road, operate the road. Operate means what? Take the money of the tolls, so that you will get your invested cost as well as your profit. Then transfer that road to the government. Okay, this system is known as BOT: build, operate, and transfer. Okay, by this system, the many of the highways are built. Many of the highways are constructed by this system, BOT. In detail, what is BOT? You will learn in the final year. There is a subject, estimating and costing. In that subject, there is a point BOT. Okay, in that subject, you will going to learn what is mean by BOT in detail. Then next point is to fix up the date-wise properties for the development of the each road link based on the utility as main criterion for facing the road development program. Okay, you have to fix the date-wise property. Okay, what is the development of road is going on link based on the utility of the main utility is taken as the main criteria for the daily progress that you have to maintain for the whatever we have to whenever you are going to develop a road. Okay, you have to prepare day-wise list that what is going on day-wise. Okay, you have to fix up the dates wise properties for the development of the each road based on the its utility. Okay, how the utility of the road is going on, tolls kiti bette, how much toll we get from that roads, etc. Okay, how the utility is there, that we have to think about that road. Then we have to plan for the future requirements and the improvement of the road in the view of anticipated development. Okay, we have to think that whether we have to go for the widening of road in the future. जब हम road construct करते हैं तो ये ध्यान में रखना चाहिए फ्यूचर में इसका वाइडनिंग हमको करना पड़ेगा या नहीं। अगर ट्रैफिक ज्यादा हो गया तो हमको क्या करना पड़ता है, रोड है तो वाइडनिंग करना। इफ द ट्रैफिक इंक्रीजेस वी हैव टू वाइडन द रोड इन द फ्यूचर। ओके, सो वी हैव टू थिंक नाउ ओनली, बिकॉज एज वी गो इन टू द वाइडनिंग फॉर द फ्यूचर देन वी हैव टू अक्वायर द लैंड एंड द फ्यूचर एज। सो बिफोर दैट ओनली नाउ ओनली अक्वायर द लैंड एज मच यू रिक्वायर एज थिंकिंग फॉर द फ्यूचर। बाय थिंकिंग द फ्यूचर वट एवर द लैंड इज रिक्वायर्ड नाउ ओनली वी हैव टू डिसाइड एंड अक्वायर दैट मच अमाउंट ऑफ द लैंड। ओके, सो दैट वी हैव टू थिंक ऑफ द फ्यूचर रिक्वायरमेंट्स एंड द इम्प्रूवमेंट्स ऑफ द रोड इन द व्यू ऑफ एंटिसिपेटेड डेवलपमेंट्स। ओके, इफ यू हैव टू गो फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द रोड इन द फ्यूचर नाउ ओनली वी हैव टू थिंक सो दैट द इन फ्यूचर देर विल नॉट बी एनी डिस्टर्बेंस while acquiring the road or the land. Then to work out the financing system, very importantly, financial system is most important in the road system. We have to think about the financing to if we want a minimum cost of the highway, what we have to done, whatever the cutting and filling is there. If you know what is cutting, what is filling. Cutting means what? If there is, first we have to decide the RLs. Okay, you may, might you have seen in the surveying. Surveying mein aapne padha hoga. RLs mean what? Reduced level. We have, when we align the road, we have to decide the RL of the road. Okay, reduced level. By deciding their RL, while deciding that RL, we have to decide such that the cutting and filling should be maintained. Okay, there will how much will be the cutting? There will be only the filling, so that we will get the optimum amount of cost of that highway. What is cutting and filling? I will show one image for that. Okay, see here. What is cutting and what is filling? I will show here. See here. Okay, this is the land, cross section of the bench. Only the upper image. Okay, see only the upper image. This one. Okay. In this image, what is cutting and filling? See, the dark line. Which shows the ground level. Okay, the ground is undulating. इधर क्या है? Upper hill है. इधर down. इधर up है. इधर down. Okay, like this the road ground is there. We need to construct the road through this ground. Okay, this level dark line shows the ground. Okay, and we need to construct the road through this ground. Then what we have to decide the line. See this dotted line shown here. Dotted line shown here is the RL of the road, reduced level. Okay, that is alignment of the road. This alignment we have decided. Why we have decided this alignment? we have to decide the alignment such that the cutting, see, the here is the upper, okay, the road is, the ground level is upper, upside, than the road level, okay, that means we have to cut this portion. समझ में आ रहा है? ये जो आ रहा है ग्राउंड लेवल है, ओके, और ये डॉटेड लाइन जो है तो हमारा रोड लेवल है. We have to road construct the road by this dotted line. Okay. इस dotted line through अपना road क्या है construct करने का. ये ground जो है dotted line के ऊपर है. So that हमको ये क्या करने का है, cut करने का है. Upper जो portion है इसको cut करने का dotted line से upper का. This is called as cutting. Now moving forward, see here. The dotted line ground level से ऊपर है इधर. Okay. Ground level नीचे है और dotted line ऊपर है. So that we have to fill the material here. समझ में आ रहा है? Dotted line ऊपर है और ground level नीचे है. That is what we need to fill the material here. Okay. Then moving forward, see here. The dotted line is downward and the ground level is upward. Okay. Dotted line नीचे है और ground level ऊपर है. इसलिए हमें इस part को क्या करना पड़ेगा? Cut करना पड़ेगा. We have to cut this portion. Then moving forward, this is dotted line, this is ground line. इधर क्या है? इधर हमको material fill करना पड़ेगा क्योंकि road line है जो ऊपर है, ground level नीचे है. Okay, so road level maintain करने के लिए हमको यहाँ fill करना पड़ेगा. Okay, means what? This is called as filling. Means we have to fill the material here. We have to cut the material from here. This is called as cutting. We should have to decide the alignment of the road such that the cutting area should be equal to filling area. Keep in mind, we should decide the alignment such that the cutting area should be equal to filling area. Why? Because whatever the cost we require to fill the material, it is reduced because the material we have to fill, the material we are getting nearby. ओके, सपोज हमने ये लाइन है ऊपर से लिया तो हमको क्या हो गया, जो फिलिंग एरिया है इसमें मटेरियल ज्यादा लगेगा. ओके, सपोज अगर फिलिंग मटेरियल ज्यादा लगेगा तो हमको क्या करना पड़ेगा, दूर कहीं से तो मटेरियल ट्रांसपोर्ट करके लाना पड़ेगा, उस जगह फिल करना पड़ेगा अगर घटा हो तो. ओके, देन द कंस्ट्रक्शन कॉस्ट ऑटोमेटिकली गो राइजेस. ओके, हमका कॉस्ट क्या होगा, बढ़ेगा. क्यों? क्योंकि हमको मटेरियल है वो दूर से ट्रांसपोर्ट करके लाना पड़ता है और उस गड्ढे में फिल करना पड़ता है. ठीक है, इसके जगह हमने क्या किया, ऐसा रोड अलाइनमेंट फिक्स किया जिसकी वजह से क्या होगा, जो कटिंग पोर्शन हमको कट करना है उतना ही पोर्शन हमको फिल करना है. मीन्स व्हाट, सपोज हमने कटिंग है जो 10 m³ कट किया है और हमको भी नियर अबाउट 10 m³ ही मटेरियल रिक्वायर्ड है फिलिंग करने, गड्ढा फिल करने के लिए. सो क्या उसमें क्या होगा, वट एवर वी आर कटिंग दैट पोर्शन वी हैव टू यूज एज अ फिलिंग पोर्शन. ओके, जो भी हम कट कर रहे हैं वो सब हम फिलिंग करने के लिए गड्ढे में यूज कर रहे हैं. उसमें से क्या होगा, इसका फायदा हमको दूर से कहीं से मटेरियल जो है वो लाना नहीं पड़ेगा, मटेरियल ट्रांसपोर्ट करना नहीं पड़ेगा इधर. ओके, सो दैट इस हमारा ट्रांसपोर्टेशन कॉस्ट बच जाएगा, मटेरियल जो हम दूसरी जगह से ला रहे हैं उसको मटेरियल का कॉस्ट बच जाएगा. ठीक है, सो वी विल गेट द ऑप्टिमम कॉस्ट. ऑप्टिमम कॉस्ट के लिए हमको क्या ध्यान में रखना चाहिए, जो भी कटिंग है उतना ही फिलिंग होना चाहिए, यानी कि हम जितना कट कर रहे हैं उतना ही उस गड्ढे में फिल करें. ओके, रोड लाइन मैच करने के लिए. ओके, सो दैट वी कीप इन माइंड कटिंग शुड बी इक्वल टू फिलिंग. ये जो प्लानिंग है हाईवे के, ये हमको ध्यान में रखना चाहिए. वी विल मूव फॉरवर्ड फॉर द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. ओके, दीज आर द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द हाईवे. प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ द हाईवे हमने देखे अब. देन वी विल मूव फॉरवर्ड रोड डेवलपमेंट इन द इंडिया. From the back, back to the question. Okay, हमारा road development कैसा है? हम आप देखेंगे. आपने सुना तो होगा इंडस वैली, मोहनजोदड़ो, हड़प्पा सिविलाइजेशन, जो हम एक्सकैवेशन में मिले थे, उसका स्टडी है। यानी कि रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लानिंग जो है वो बहुत सालों से चल रहा है। इसका ये प्रूफ है कि हमें एक्सकैवेशन में हड़प्पा सिविलाइजेशन में मिला, मोहनजोदड़ो से मिला, इंडस वैली से मिला, यानी कि हमारे जो पूर्वज थे वो भी इसका यूज करते थे। सो We will see now the road development in the India. Okay, how the road were developed into the India from the long years ago. Okay, so 2500 to 3500 BC, there is the Indus Valley civilization, then Mohenjo-daro, Hadappa civilization was there. Okay, we have got the proof of that also in the excavation in that area. So the road development we are there that time also, that is the proof of that. Then the Maurya king built a very good roads in the in the Maurya king's nation we have got the symptoms of the road that he had built the very good roads. Then most importantly, Kautilya's Arthashastra. Okay, this is the book that in his book he have given the certain rules and regulations how to use the roads, how to regulate the traffic, okay, depth of the roads for the various purposes. If you use for various heavy roads, heavy vehicles, light vehicles, what should be the depth, then what are the punishment that should have to given for the not obeying that traffic rules. Okay, this is given by the Kautilya in his book, that is Kautilya's Arthashastra, in the ancient days. Okay, this is the book, that book, Kautilya's Arthashastra, the way of financing the management and the economic governance. How the Kautilya Arthashastra written about 2400 years ago can solve the many of Indian current economy and other problems. He have give that rules and regulations 2400 years ago. Okay, that rules today also are helpful for while developing the road. Then in the Mughal Empire also, they have built a very nice roads linking the northwest and the eastern areas to the gigantic plains were built during this time. Okay, in the Mughal Empire also, they have built a road very nicely in the northwest and the eastern areas. Then in the British rule also, they have constructed the Grand Trunk Roads connecting the north and south, is the major contribution of the British. See this red line road. This red line denotes the road that named as Grand Trunk Road. Okay, this was built by the British. Okay, this is built by the British, which connects the north and south, major contributions. Okay, then they have formed a Jaikar committee in the 1927. they may ask the year as the our question. Exam is MCQ oriented. Keep in mind the years. Okay, the Jaikar committee were introduced in 1927. Okay, the road development committee with the M.R. Jaikar as the chairman. The M.R. Jaikar were the chairman. By his name, the Jaikar committee is established in 1927. This committee is came to known as the Jaikar committee. Committee suggested that the central government should take the proper charge, considering it as the matter of national interest. Okay, the road development planning should be done by the keeping in mind the national interest. Okay, that is given or decided by that committee. So more stress on the formulate the plans and implement those plans within the year next 20 years. So they have planned the road development such as for keeping in the mind for the next 20 years. Okay, they have planned roads such that by keeping the view of next 20 years. Then introduction of the development fund called as the Central Road Development. Then new committee is established named as the Central Road Fund. Okay, and 1929. Then establishment of the semi-official technician body called as Indian Road Congress, IRC. Okay, IRC, we have seen this word many a times in the highway. We will see this name in many a time. This may be asked for MCQ. What is the full form of IRC? So what is IRC? IRC is the Indian Road Congress, which is built in 1934. Okay, this is the committee which built in the 1934. It gives the various standards how to build the highway, what should be the length, what should be the width for the single lane, two lane, three lane, okay, etc. Like that, many rules and regulations for the highway are given by the IRC, and we are following now also the IRC standards. Then they have formed a Central Road Research Institute, that is CRRI, in 1950. Okay, keep in mind these developments. ये ध्यान में रखना चाहिए कि कौन सी कमिटी कौन से ईयर में फॉर्म हुई. दिस में भी आस्क फॉर द मैच द पीयर में भी आस्क होगा या फिर एमसीक्यू भी इसके ऊपर आएगा. जेकर कमेटी कब इस्टेब्लिश हुई? 1927. सेंट्रल रोड फंड 1929. इंडियन रोड कांग्रेस 1934. एंड सेंट्रल रोड रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट दैट इज CRRI 1950. द फुल फॉर्म में भी आस्क, फुल फॉर्म ऑल्सो में आस्क, CRRI का फुल फॉर्म क्या है? सो CRRI मीन्स सेंट्रल रोड रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट. ओके, दिस कमिटी इज फॉर्म इन 1950. ओके, we have to keep the full form as well as the year of establishments of these committees. Okay, then the Nagpur Road Congress 1943. This is also known as Nagpur Road Development Plan. Okay, Nagpur Road Development Plan, these results of the conference in the famous as Nagpur Plan. Okay, Nagpur Plan, this is also known as named as Nagpur Plan. Okay, this is 20 years development program for the period of 1943 to the 1963 was finalized. ये ध्यान में रखने का है. ये क्या है? First 20 years plan. This is also called as first 20 years plan. और इस plan में क्या decide किया कि हमको अगले 20 साल तक, अगले 20 साल तक जो भी developments करने हैं. Developments in the sense what? For the road or the highway development. वो क्या करने का है? इसमें वो क्या किया है? उन्होंने committee ने क्या किया? Next 20 years development जो का जो भी plans है, वो plans decide किए. Okay? और वो next development plan 20 years का कौन सा region था? 1943 to the 63. ये ध्यान में रखने का years. Okay? First 20 years plan is Nagpur Plan, and this is for the period of 1943 to the 63. This is very important MCQ view. for MCQ point of view. Then in this, the roads are categorized as national highway, state highway, district road and village road. Okay, Nagpur road plan mein roads hai jo divide kiye gaye. Okay, kaise divide kiye? Okay, we are discussing about the Nagpur road development plan. In this plan, we have to focus on what? This is the I will tell you the MCQ oriented question. Okay, this is the first 20 years development plan that might be asked, and this plan is constructed. This plan decides to construct the roads. This plan is finalized for years of 1943 to the 1963. Okay, this is a 20 year plan. Development program for the period of 1943 to the 1963 was finalized. Okay, यह आपको याद में रखना है कि this Nagpur plan जो है वो कौन से साल के लिए था? 20 years plan है, yes we know, but कौन से साल से कौन से साल में? Okay, this plan we are decided from the year of 1943 up to the year of 1963. Okay, for these 20 years. Then Nagpur Road Development Plan had divided the roads as the National Highway, State Highway, District Roads and Village Road. Also in the District Road, there are two types, Major District Road and Ordinary District Roads. Okay, MDR and ODR. MDR means what? Major District Roads, ODR, Ordinary District Roads. Okay, then then the Nagpur Road for Development Plan Committee has decided to construct the 2 lakhs of kilometer of the road across the country within 20 years. So, but they have decided to construct the 2 lakh kilometers of the road and in 20 years. Okay, this we have to keep in mind. This is very important. The MCQ related 2 lakhs kilometer per of road in 20 years. And they recommended the construction of star and grid pattern. What is star and grid pattern? That we will see at the end of this chapter. We have the different types of the road. Okay, star and grid, rectangular. Okay, there are many types of the pattern of to construct the roads. Okay, that we have see at this end of this first chapter. Now this one. Now at this stage, just keep in mind the Nagpur Road Development Plan recommended the construction of the roads of star and grid pattern. This is very important. Then the road density of 16 kilometers per 100 square. Okay, they have decided to construct the roads with the density of 16 kilometers per 100 किलोमीटर स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ द रोड मींस व्हाट जो 100 किलोमीटर स्क्वायर का जो एरिया होगा उसमें एटलीस्ट 16 किलोमीटर रोड होने चाहिए समझ में आया डेंसिटी मींस व्हाट सपोज वी हैव टेक द 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर ऑफ द एरिया इन दैट एरिया वी शुड एटलीस्ट हैव टू डेवलप अ 16 किलोमीटर ऑफ द रोड ओके दिस इज द की पॉइंट्स ऑफ द नागपुर डेवलपमेंट प्लान ओके वी हैव टू keep in mind these points. Okay, then next development plan is Bombay Road Congress, or it is also called as Bombay Road Plan. This is also called as second 20 years road plan. Okay, first 20 years plan kaun sa tha? Nagpur. Second 20 years development plan kaun sa hai? Bombay. Okay, it was the second 20 years plan, and this is from 1961 to 1981. Pehla kaun sa tha? 1943 to 1963. Okay, iska kalam ka jo bhi decided kaam tha, wo 1961 mein hi second committee iski establish hui, aur 1961 mein hi inhone next 20 years ka plan hai jo build kiya. नेक्स्ट 20 ईयर्स का प्लान कौन सी ईयर में था, 1961 टू 1981, ओके, दैट वी हैव टू कीप इन माइंड. द सेकंड 20 ईयर्स डेवलपमेंट प्लान वाज फ्रॉम 1961 अप टू द 1981, ओके. द टोटल रोड लेंथ टारगेटेड टू कंस्ट्रक्ट वाज अबाउट 10 लाख. फर्स्ट 20 ईयर्स डेवलप नागपुर प्लान में कितना टारगेट था, 2 लाख ऑफ किलोमीटर ऑफ द रोड. नेक्स्ट बॉम्बे रोड डेवलपमेंट में कितना है टारगेट, 10 लाख किलोमीटर ऑफ रोड. देन रोड डेंसिटी 32 किलोमीटर पर 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. ओके, नागपुर डेवलपमेंट प्लान में कितना था, 16 किलोमीटर पर 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. बॉम्बे डेवलपमेंट प्लान में कितना है, 32 किलोमीटर पर 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. ओके, दिस इज द रोड डेंसिटी दे हैव प्लान टू बी अचीव्ड इन द सेकंड 20 ईयर्स रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान. देन द कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ 1600 किलोमीटर ऑफ द एक्सप्रेस वे वॉज ऑल्सो देन इंक्लूडेड इन दिस प्लान. ओके, नागपुर प्लान में रोड जो है, नागपुर प्लान में रोड डिवाइड जो किए हैं हमने, दिस रोड्स आर डिवाइडेड इनटू द नेशनल हाईवे, स्टेट हाईवे, डिस्ट्रिक्ट हाईवे एंड विलेज हाईवे. ओके, विलेज रोड्स. बट इन द बॉम्बे डेवलपमेंट प्लान दे हैव ऑल्सो इंट्रोड्यूस द एक्सप्रेस वेज. इन द बॉम्बे रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान दे हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड द एक्सप्रेस वे एंड दे हैव डिसाइडेड टू कंस्ट्रक्ट द 1600 किलोमीटर ऑफ एक्सप्रेस वे इन द बॉम्बे रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान. ओके, दिस की पॉइंट्स वी हैव टू रिमेम्बर. ओके, ये ध्यान में रखने से उस सारे की पॉइंट्स. देन लखनऊ रोड कांग्रेस, ओके, दिस इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज थर्ड 20 ईयर्स डेवलपमेंट प्लान. ओके, तीन ही है, फर्स्ट डेवलपमेंट प्लान नागपुर, सेकंड डेवलपमेंट प्लान बॉम्बे, और थर्ड डेवलपमेंट रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान कौन सा है, वो लखनऊ. ओके, थर्ड 20 ईयर्स प्लान इज द ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज लखनऊ प्लान. ओके, दिस वॉज द थर्ड 20 ईयर्स प्लान विच इज एस्टेब्लिश्ड फ्रॉम 1981 टू द 2001. ओके, दिस इज प्लान्ड बाय द 1981 अप टू द 2001. इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज लखनऊ रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान. इट एम्ड एट कंस्ट्रक्टिंग अ रोड लेंथ ऑफ 12 लाख किलोमीटर by the year of 1981, resulting in the road density of 82 kilometers per 100 square kilometer. Okay, third development plan Lucknow mein kya decide kiya, to build a 12 lakh kilometer roads and with the density of 82 kilometers per 100 square kilometer. Okay, first Nagpur plan mein kitna humne plan kiya tha road develop karne ka, 2 lakhs. बॉम्बे में 10 और लखनऊ में 12 लाख. ओके, रोड डेंसिटी नागपुर प्लान में कितनी थी, 16 किलोमीटर पर 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. बॉम्बे में कितनी थी, बॉम्बे डेवलपमेंट प्लान में 32 किलोमीटर पर 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर, एंड इन द लखनऊ रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान इट इज 82 किलोमीटर पर 100 स्क्वायर किलोमीटर. दिस इज द रोड डेंसिटी विच इज डिसाइडेड टू बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड इन द लखनऊ रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान. ओके, सो दीज आर द 3 20 ईयर्स रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान एंड दीज आर द वेरी मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट रोड डेवलपमेंट प्लान दैट वी हैव टू कीप इन माइंड. ओके, then here is a comparative of all these three plans, first 20 years, second 20 years, third 20 years plan. The first 20 year plan's name is Nagpur, second 20 years name is Bombay, and third 20 years name is Lucknow Road Development. Okay, take a screenshot of this. This is very important as the MCQ point of view. ये हमसे के लिए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट है ये. So take a screenshot of this. Then duration. First road development plan जो है उसका duration कितना था 1943 to the 1963. Okay. Then second 20 years development plan जो है उसका duration कितना था 1961 to 1981. And third जो duration है लखनऊ plan का 1981 to 2000. This is very important durations of the roads. Then the target road length. What are the targets given to build the road? In the first 20 years, that is Nagpur Road Development Plan, the target is given to build a 2 lakhs of kilometer road. Yeah, okay, in 20 years, they have targeted to build a 2 lakh kilometer road. Then in the Bombay Road Development Plan, they have decided to construct 10 lakhs of kilometer road in 20 years. Okay. And in the Lucknow Road Development Plan, they have decided to build or to construct a 12 lakhs of kilometer road in 20 years. Then road density in the Nagpur Road Development Plan, they have decided to go by the density of 16 kilometer per 100 square kilometer. Then in the Bombay Development Plan, that is second 20-year plan, 32 kilometer per 100 square kilometer. And in third 20 years plan, that is Lucknow, 82 kilometer per 100 square kilometer. This is the density they have decided to achieve while constructing the road. Then the road network pattern. This is also very important. What are the patterns they have decided to use? In the Nagpur Road Development Plan, they have to they decided to use the road network pattern as star and grid. Okay. In the Bombay, they have not decided. And in the Lucknow, they have decided square grid pattern to build the roads. Okay. This is important. And what are these patterns? We will see at the end of this chapter. We have that point also in this our syllabus. Then the classification of the roads. In the Nagpur Development Plan, they have classified the road as NH, SH, ODR, and PR. Okay. MDR is missing here. MDR is also there. NH, SH, MDR, ODR, and VR. What is NH? National Highway. SH, State Highway. MDR, Major District Roads. ODR, Ordinary District Road, and VR, that is Village Road. Okay. In the next 20 years, that is Bombay, they have just added the expressway into that. Sirf kya add kiya isme? Expressway. Okay. That is means what? Expressway, National Highway, State Highway, Major District Roads, Ordinary District Roads, and Village Roads. Okay. Then in the last 20 years plan, that is Lucknow, they have classified the road as primary, secondary, and tertiary. Okay. Yaha kya divide kiya hai roads ko? Teen part mein divide kiya hai. Primary, secondary, and tertiary. In the primary, they have included expressway and national highways. Please listen carefully. In the primary road development, in the primary classification of the road, they have taken expressway and national highway. Okay. In the secondary road system, they have taken state highway and major district roads. And in the last, that is third tertiary road system, they have taken as ordinary district road and the village road. Means tertiary road system is depends on what? Village roads. Okay. They are developed as the rural roads, tertiary system. Keep in mind, the classification of roads in the Lucknow, it is classified as primary, secondary, and tertiary. In primary, they have taken expressway and national highway. Same, in the Bombay there is also expressway, national highway, state highway, major district road, ordinary district road and village road. Yes, they have categorized into the three parts. First two, that is expressway and national way, that is taken in the primary. Then next two, state highway and major district roads, they have taken in secondary. And last two, ordinary and village roads. Ordinary district roads and village road, they have taken as the tertiary roads. Okay. This is the classification of road in Lucknow system. Then expressway length to build. In the Nagpur system, they have not developed the expressway or not decided to build the expressways. They have started to build the expressway from the Bombay development plan. Okay. And in the Bombay development plan, they have decided to build a 1600 kilometers of the expressway. Okay. And in the Lucknow, they have decided to build a 2000 kilometers of the expressway. Okay. This is very, very important table. Please take a screenshot of this and read carefully for multiple times. Okay. Definitely MCQ will be asked on this table. Definitely. Surely the MCQ will be asked on this table. Okay. Then the classification of the roads. Okay. Only five minutes have remained. Best. There is a very large part. We'll take this part in the next lecture only by the fresh mood. Just keep in mind this table. I will take attendance. After that, just read this table carefully. Okay.